Hey, sixth grade. I just wanted to come and clear some things up for you. I know that it's been a while since we've been together, and there's a lot of things going on. So I don't want anyone to feel badly if they're struggling with remembering complements or figuring out adjectives. I just want you to get as much help as you can, and hopefully when we all get back together, we will all be on the same page. So about complements, I want to remind you of a few things. I want to remind you about the different complements for the different verbs. If you remember, action verbs get direct objects and sometimes indirect objects. So an action verb is something you can do. Right here, I have an example. Jordan kicked the ball. Okay? So the action is kicked. And who kicked? Well, Jordan kicked. And then when you ask the questions, what did he kick? He kicked the ball. And this isn't part of the sentence right now. So Jordan kicked the ball. The ball is receiving the action. That's what he kicked. So that's why we call it a direct object, because it's an object that received the action. Okay? Now, Toby threw Kalana the ball. I think you remember it was actually one of the last days we were here, if I'm remembering correctly. We kind of mentioned stuff like this. He didn't throw Kalana, right? Toby didn't pick up Kalana and throw him. So Kalana cannot be the direct object because that's not what he threw. He threw the ball, but to Kalana. Eventually, Kalana received that, right? Eventually, indirectly. So Toby threw the ball, but it was to Kalana. And if you remember, an indirect object always comes right in between the verb and the direct object. So somewhere in between those two is where the indirect object comes. So when you are doing your worksheet that I created for you, I want you to think, what kind of complements does an action verb get? These are the objects, the receiving action. Okay? Now, linking verbs, your first eight are am, is, are, was, were, be, being, been. These are the easy ones. Of course, it goes into taste, feel, smell, sound, look, appear, become, seem, grow, remain, stay. There are more, but these are the main ones that are used. Now, taste, feel, smell, sound, look, appear, become, seem, grow, remain, stay. Those are actually used for predicate adjectives, which are new. So I'm going to stick with just am, is, are, was, were, being, been for now, just to illustrate. Okay? So do you see how I put an equal sign here? That's because a predicate nominative, which is a noun or pronoun, that means it's a person, a place, a thing, or an idea, usually just person, place, thing, is equal to what the subject is. So a predicate adjective, it just describes the subject. It tells you something about the subject. A predicate nominative kind of names the subject. And let's look at this. Cammie is nice. Okay, so we see is, so we automatically know that's a linking verb. We're probably going to have one of these. So Cammie is, and then nice just describes her. It just tells me something that describes her. That's an adjective. It's not a person. Nice isn't a person. Nice isn't a place. Nice isn't a thing. So that's why we call that an adjective. A predicate adjective comes after a linking verb. A predicate nominative, this is an example. Mrs. Walker is our teacher. So we see the is again, right? So we know, hey, that's linking. We're probably going to have P something, right? And teacher is a person. Every teacher I know is a person. If you think like that has to be a noun, so we call it a predicate nominative. And does Mrs. Walker equal teacher? Yeah. Does Cammie equal nice? Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. But over here, and this is where that little trick comes in handy. Jordan doesn't equal ball, and Toby doesn't equal Kalana or ball. Okay. So the equals thing only really works with the linking verbs, and of course, it gets a little bit different when you use the taste, feel, smell, sound, look, appear, become, seem, grow, remain, stay. If you said the food tastes delicious, the food equals delicious. And delicious describes it, so that's an adjective. Okay, so that's where those taste, feel, smell, sound comes in when you're describing things. The am, is, are, was, those are mostly used for predicate nominatives, and they can be used for predicate adjectives. But the taste, feel, smell, those things are only used for the adjectives. And that might have been a little too much. But I hope that this helps. I'm giving you a worksheet that'll be due, and hopefully you can just understand it a little bit better and practice it. All right, thank you for Thank you for all that you're doing. I know you guys are working hard and I really appreciate it. I hope to see you soon.